All right. Hi there. My name's Elise Beck, and I'm a product marketing manager here at HubSpot. And today I'd like to walk you through my 7 tips for adding live chat to your website for the very first time. Now, before I dive in, I do want to let you know I'm going to run through my slides, and then I'm actually going to dive right into HubSpot software and show you how to do all of this using HubSpot's free conversations tool. So let's dive in. Tip number one, before you do anything else, you want to ask yourself, why are you adding live chat to your website? What do you want to get out of it? This might seem like an obvious question, right? The number one reason to add live chat to your website is that it's going to allow you to increase conversions. You're giving your site visitors this awesome opportunity to connect directly with your sales team, to ask those burning questions that they have right there when they're most engaged, when they're already browsing your site. But there are actually a number of things that you can do with live chat, a number of ways you can get value out of this tool. One example that I love is this idea of using live chat as a way to collect feedback and better understand your buyer persona. So as a marketer, I spend a ton of time kind of writing copy for different web pages, and you can learn so much by looking at the chat transcripts that come through from some of those pages. Really try to look at, you know, where are folks getting confused? What do people have questions about? And how can you use that to then go back and improve the quality of those pages and all the copy that exists. So there are a number of things you can do with live chat, but the number one thing you want to do going into it is make sure that you have a clearly defined goal and that you really understand why you're adding live chat to your website. So the second tip I have for you is really trying to think through, where is this going to live? Of course, you have a number of different pages on your website, but you want to stay focused on, you know, what pages is this really going to provide value on? So if you're focused on conversions, you really want to focus on those high intent pages. These are things like your pricing page or the pages that outline your product or service offering. So you want to think through, you know, what pages do I want this to live on? But you also want to think through, what is the thought process of folks who are visiting these pages? Where are they in their journey? And how can we target and cater this message so it speaks more specifically to those individuals? So again, make sure we're thinking about, where is this thing going to live? Tip number three, who is going to see it? All kinds of people visit your website every single day. You have your customers, prospects, and folks who have never, ever been to your website before. So you really want to think through, who do I want to be able to see this message, and how can I target this message so that it speaks a little bit more specifically to those folks? For example, you might want to have a slightly different message targeting your customers, and you might want them to be routed to their account manager or to your support team versus net new people who've never been to your site before. Maybe you want them to be greeted by a sales rep who can qualify them, or maybe even a bot that can qualify them. So you really want to kind of just think through those different audiences and really be super specific about who you want to see this message and how you can just target it so it speaks a little bit more specifically to them. Tip number four is to think about all the things. So when you add live chat to your website, you create this incredible opportunity for folks to connect directly with your brand. You want to make sure that that experience is flawless, that you're putting your best foot forward. That means things like making sure that your chat widget matches the look and feel of your brand, making sure that your brand voice shines through in the language that you develop for your live chat widget, all of those things. And I'll talk more about some other ways that you can kind of improve the overall experience as we dive into the demo. Tip number five is to create snippets. What is a snippet? It is a short bit of copy, so a paragraph or a couple of lines of text that is a commonly used kind of phrase. So for example, folks are always asking you this specific question about your pricing. You can create the response to that as a snippet. This is great for a number of reasons. The first is that it allows your team to be really efficient with their replies, to get those questions and inquiries handled quickly. The other thing, and perhaps the most important thing, is that it allows your team to be really consistent with their replies, right? So with snippets, you can really ensure that everyone is kind of getting the same reply rather for those commonly asked questions, which is great. Tip number six is to stay organized, right? Again, live chat is a way to connect with your site visitors. You want to make sure that you're really kind of having everything in place to nurture those relationships, turn prospects into customers. You know, you don't want to let anyone fall through the cracks. You don't want to leave anyone with a bad taste in their mouth or a bad experience. You really want to stay organized. Make sure you have everything in place to know, you know, has this person chatted with us before? How can I make sure that we're following up with them with anything that they need? So I'll show you some tips for staying organized there. And tip number seven is that you really want to make sure that you're giving value in order to get value, right? Like I said, live chat is an awesome way to increase conversions, but you don't want to go into it with dollar signs in your eyes. You want to be focused on providing your site visitors with value, helping them along the way, answering any questions that they have. That is the primary thing that you want to be focused on. You know, over time, those folks will lead into conversions and more customers and all that good stuff. But for now, you really want to make sure that you're focused on just being helpful and providing that guidance from the get-go. So those are my seven tips. Now I want to dive into the demo and show you how all this goes into play. But first, I want to do a quick recap to show you kind of what I'm thinking and kind of set the stage for the demo. So the first tip was, why are we adding live chat? For the case of this example, we are going to add live chat to our website to increase conversions. Where is this live chat widget going to live? We're going to add it to our pricing page. Who are we going to target with this message? We are going to focus on making sure that our marketing qualified leads see this message. All the things, I'll show you how to adjust the look and feel, set up your availability and office hours, and I'll also show you how to set up those rep profiles, which is just another way to add a little bit more personalization to the live chat experience. I'll show you how to create some snippets and also how to use filters and how you can use HubSpot to manage kind of your follow-up once you have that initial conversation with a contact. And lastly, give value to get value. Unfortunately, I don't have a great tool for that, but it's something that will come in training as long as you kind of equip your team with the right mindset and the right tools to make sure that they're providing value and really helping out the folks that they're chatting with. So with that, let's dive on in. So this is my conversations inbox. You can see here it's right in the main nav. Click into my inbox. And we are going to create a targeted message. So first up, and this is the kind of standard setup flow for folks who've never set up a live chat message in HubSpot yet. So this is what you'll experience for the first time you're setting things up. So first you can set the appearance of your live chat widget. So you can choose from a number of these pretty gradient options, or you can add your hex code, which is awesome. So if you have brand colors that you prefer to use, you can easily drop in that hex code here and you'll be good to go. For the sake of this example, I'm going to use this nice purple color here. So next up, you'll have the option to set your availability. What this does is really kind of set the best possible expectations with site visitors on how your team will reply to your live chat messages, right? So if you're a big team, maybe you have the ability to keep your live chat staffed around the clock. But for a lot of teams, that just isn't a possibility. And so there are a few different ways that you can set this up so that you can really service as many people as possible and set the right expectations with folks for those times where you aren't able to staff the live chat. So let me explain what these different options are. First, you can set your live chat so that it's only visible during business hours, which means from 9 to 5, for example, when your team's in the office, that live chat widget will appear in the corner of your page and folks will be able to chat in. You can also set it so that your availability is based on team member availability. So as long as there's a member of your team who's available to chat, that live chat widget will appear as online and available to chat. Or you can set it so that you're always online. Again, this is a great option if you do have the bandwidth to keep your live chat fully staffed, or also sometimes teams that are super small like this option because they can get notified on their phone and quickly kind of reply and follow up with those folks to keep the conversation going. I'm going to set this up so that it's during business hours. So I'm going to say Monday through Friday, 9 to 6, we will be online. And I have a few more settings here. I can set the expectation for how quickly we'll reply. So when folks type in, maybe I reply in a few hours, in a few minutes, you can customize the response. I'm going to say that we reply in a few minutes. You can also set an away message in the case that your team is, everyone is away, this will appear. And you can show when it's outside business hours. So in this case, let's say it's 7 p.m., you can decide what you want to show. You can show the return time, you can show an away message, or you can hide the chat widget entirely from your page. I'm gonna show the return time, which will just let folks know that I'll be back online at 9 a.m. So next up, I have the option to select my audience. Now remember, for this example, I want to target marketing qualified leads, but I have a few options here. First, I can choose to target this message so that anyone who visits my site will see it. I have the option to target anonymous visitors, so only those visitors who are not yet in my database will see the message. I can target it so that only tracked contacts will see it. That means only people who are in my HubSpot CRM will be able to see the message. Or I can choose from a segmented list. This is where I'll select my marketing qualified leads. And I also do have this option down here to choose a suppression list. So if there is a group of folks who I do not want them to see this message, I can choose that list here as well. Next up, we have our targeting. Now, this is going to go on the pricing page, but this is also my demo portal, so I'm going to make sure that I have my demo demo site there. But let's say we also want it to be on our pricing page. We can add that here. Great. Next up, you want to come up with your welcome message. So again, this is where it's so important for you to have thought about where this message is going to live, who's going to see it. Really think through all these things so we can come up with a nice, targeted, and specific message for this audience. So I'm going to say, hi there, have a question about our pricing. We're happy to help. Or I'll say, I'm happy to help, because we're going to be targeting folks who are already in the system, so they should have contact owner, which brings us to the next point. You can choose who you want this message to be sent from, whether that's you want it to come on behalf of a certain team or group of individuals. I want to make this so that it comes from our contact owner. What that means is if a person has converted, which our marketing qualified leads will have converted somewhere, they will have been assigned a HubSpot contact owner. That's a person who's responsible for kind of nurturing them through the sales process and ultimately turning them into a customer. So basically their sales rep. And when I select this, that basically means that their sales rep will be the face that they see when they hit the pricing page, and it's the face that will greet them, and they'll be able to start chatting right away with the person that they've already been working with, which is great. You can add a fallback here. So in the case that their sales rep isn't online, it'll still get surfaced to someone else who can help answer their questions. So I'm gonna choose my BDR team there. You also have the option to capture email. I'm gonna set this so that if no team member responds after a minute, we'll collect their email address. So I want this, again, to go to the contact owner because I want those folks who already have a relationship with the contact to be able to continue that relationship, to be able to build that relationship and keep that connection going. And I'll select a visitor fallback just in case they don't have that contact, or that contact that they have isn't available, we'll be able to get our BDR team on it so that they can still help. So I can preview the message, I can name it. This looks a little weird because again, this is my test demo portal. But next you can install the the code snippet, if it's already on your page, you don't have to do anything. So it's really easy if you need to send it to a developer or embed the code yourself, you can easily do that. But if you already have the HubSpot tracking code installed, you don't have to do anything, which is great. So now I want to show you what this looks like. I'm going to hop on over to my conversations test page here. All right, so here you can see that we are on the page. We can see the live chat widget right here. You click in and we can see that we usually reply in a few minutes. Looks like I already had a few conversations going with myself. So let me just show you how this all comes to play in the inbox itself. So here you can see that there are a bunch of filters on the side for how you can view all of the incoming conversations. You can view all conversations, only those that are assigned to you, and easily kind of jump in here and manage those. So it's really easy to type in a message. Or you can add a snippet, which I mentioned earlier. And you can easily create new snippets or manage existing ones, kind of add more context to them, whatever you want to do. So here is a test of a snippet. And of course, this would naturally be something that's a little more valuable, though my creativity is lacking at the moment. And we'll save that snippet here. So one other thing I want to show you that's pretty neat is those rep profiles. So if I go to my settings under conversations, I have the option to build out my profile. So this is where I can change, you know, how my name appears, add my job title, or add a little bit of introduction about who I am or how I can help this person. I also have the option to add my meetings link. So with HubSpot, anyone who signs up can get a free meetings link, which basically syncs to your Google or Office 365 calendar, and you can, you know, make it so that it's really easy for prospects to book that time with you. It'll sync directly to your calendar. They'll know when you're available, when you're not, all that good stuff, and they can book time right away. I'll show you how this looks back here on the demo. So let me show you this. You can see here, there's my information. And if I'm chatting in, I can click in here and have the option to schedule that time. So I'm gonna book just a 30-minute slot with myself. And we'll confirm that. And there we go. And so as a user, I would get an email letting me know that someone's booked time with me. It'll appear right on my calendar. And so we're good to go. So I think that covers everything that we went through today. Just making sure here. Again, so everything that I showed today is entirely free. It's part of HubSpot's new conversations feature. Sign up for HubSpot, you get a free conversations access. You can create live chats, you can create chatbots all for free. I encourage you to check it out. And good luck getting set up with live chat on your website for the first time. Thanks, guys.